So I recently finished my big Next.js course update, and in this course, I therefore now cover Next.js version 14 with the app router in great depth. All the essentials and also advanced concepts like authentication, caching, and so on. I'm really happy with that, and of course, therefore, I have worked a lot with Next.js over the past months and actually over the entire past year, not just for this course, but also outside of that course production. Now, of course, if you want to learn all about Next.js, if you're interested in it, you definitely might want to check out that course. I'm really happy with how it turned out. In this video and episode here, I in the end want to share my thoughts on Next.js as a whole, and especially also about Next.js 14 and the app router. And I'll share what I liked about it, what I didn't like about it, and where I think that it maybe needs more improvement in the future. And I'll start with the things I did like about the Next.js 14 and the app router specifically. For that, however, it's of course important to understand what Next.js is and where it's coming from. Now, I assume you probably have an idea of what Next.js is. It is a framework, a React framework, that simplifies the process of building React applications, mostly full stack applications. And to me, and I would guess to most developers, that has always been the main selling point of Next.js, even before the app router, that you could use it to build full stack React applications where you have a front end powered by React and a back end that's tightly connected in some way, at least, or that's at least all managed in one project, and which therefore simplifies the process of building such full stack applications. And that has been the case with the Pages router, which is the old approach of building Next.js applications as well. Now, with Next.js version 14, all the features that are required by the app router, which is the new approach of building Next.js applications, have been marked as stable. Specifically, server actions have been marked as stable with version 14. And the key difference between Pages and App Router, besides a different folder structure, to which I'll get back, the key difference in the end for me is that with the App Router, you have a tighter integration between front end and back end because Next.js with the App Router uses a concept called React Server Components, which is actually not Next.js specific, but which is relatively hard to use without Next.js, at least at the moment. And that's in the end a feature that kind of blends the boundary between front end and back end, you could argue. Because with that concept, React components can be rendered outside of the browser more easily, can be dynamically updated on the server, can be asynchronous, so you can use async await to wait for the result of some data fetching process. And therefore, with Next.js 14 and the app router, it's easier than ever, in my opinion, to build full stack React applications with Next.js because it's really simple to like fetch data from a database and ensure that that code runs on the server, and then at the same time build a highly interactive and reactive front end. Now, I will say that it's also very simple, in my opinion, to do that with Remix, which is an alternative to Next.js. But now I want to talk about Next.js, so I will focus on that. And therefore, the part I probably like the most about Next.js 14 and the app router is that it does indeed make it very simple to build feature-rich full-stack React applications. In my experience, it's really simpler to fetch data, mutate data, and also implement features like authentication in a secure and good way than it was before with the Pages router, because there you essentially still had a decoupled front end and back end, just managed in one project. And not totally decoupled, I guess. They would be served by the same server, but you would still have a backend API to which you send requests from your frontend code in the end. And with Next.js 14, that's kind of still the case, but you don't need to write any frontend data fetching code anymore. You don't need to use a fact with the fetch API or use a package like React Query to fetch data from a backend. Instead, that's all more integrated now, and that's really fun to work with and really simplifies that process of building such applications, which is why I can really fully recommend that you consider using Next.js version 14 with the app router if you're looking to build full stack React applications. And my course definitely gets you started with that and teaches you a lot of important essentials as well as some advanced concepts for that. However, there also are parts which I don't fully like yet. And there are some parts which I'll maybe never like, and some parts which probably will change in the future or will improve in the future. Now, one thing I don't like, which is not very likely to change, is the folder structure you have in Next.js projects when using the app router. And of course, that's very subjective. That can definitely be different for different people. You might like that folder structure, but I don't. Because the problem I have with it is, in the end, that you have a bunch of reserved file names like page.js, layout.js, error.js, and a couple of other names which you have to use over and over again to define pages, layouts, error fallback code, and so on. So in the end, to define routes, you create folders which, with their names, in the end represent your route path segments. And then in those folders, you must have those page.js, layout.js, and so on files. And that, of course, leads to projects where you have a lot of page.js, layout.js, and so on files flying around in different subfolders. And for me, that can make it a bit difficult or unnecessarily complex, if you want to call it like this, to switch between those files quickly in my code editor, because they all have the same file name. They only differ regarding the folder in which they are. It's not impossible by any means, and it's maybe not a big problem, but it is something I didn't like too much. Another problem I had with Next.js 14, now that I worked with it a lot, is that A, the development server can still be quite slow, which can be annoying and confusing. B, there also were still a couple of bugs in there where certain Next.js 14 features didn't work the way they shouldn't, like especially when working with intercepting and parallel routes, I faced some problems there. And I also have a problem with the fact that some behaviors are simply different in development or during development than they are in production, especially regarding caching. Because Next.js with the app router performs some pretty aggressive caching. Caching of routes, caching of data, and some other caching as well. And the problem I have is that it's not doing that in the same way during development as it does it in production. Which, of course, makes sense to some extent. You don't want to cache that much data during development. You want to have changes reflected during development. But of course, on the other hand, if you build your application and everything works during development, it might not work in production. And I do tackle this in my course, and I highlight this problem and how to be aware of it and how to fix it. But still, it is an annoyance to me that we have these differences and that we have this aggressive caching, which is not necessarily on its own a problem, but which is a problem if it then behaves in an unexpected way due to these differences. So that's also something I didn't like too much. These, however, are all problems that may change and go away in the future. Especially the performance issues and the bugs are very likely only a matter of time until we don't have these problems anymore. So that's not really too much of a problem, but still, it is something I wanted to mention here since I have worked a lot with Next.js. And therefore, at the moment, I really like Next.js, but it can have its annoyances. Still, it is probably fair to say that it's the biggest and most important React framework out there. And if you're learning React and if you want to work as a React developer, there is a high chance that you also need to learn Next.js because you might get into a job that uses Next.js or simply because it's an extra tool in your React toolbox. It enhances your skill set as a React developer. And therefore, my honest recommendation would be to definitely give Next.js a try and consider it for your upcoming React projects if they do have some kind of backend that you also work on. But you also might want to at least take a brief look at alternatives like Remix or this new TanStack framework that has been announced a couple of weeks ago at the point of time where I'm recording this. So these are interesting alternatives, but as mentioned, Next.js is the biggest one, and so therefore there really isn't a way around it. And I also don't think you have to find a way around it. You just should be aware of the fact that it's not perfect yet, but it might get there. And the app router really gives you a nice way of building those full stack React apps. These are my condensed thoughts on Next.js. Please also share yours, share your experience, your feedback. Let me know if there's something I forgot, something you see differently, and of course also if there's something I should talk about in the future, maybe something I forgot here. Happy to read your comments. Hope you have a great day. Bye.